It was just over 4 months ago when the opera ended and Dick Motta's famous fat lady broke out in song as the Washington Bullets won the NBA championship. But can Dick Motta and the Bullets stay up on top? Can they win it?
I haven't put very much pressure on him to this point. We had a very lax, as far as mental approaches concerning training camp. They work hard, physically hard. We've been out for 3 or 4 games this year. We were flat for a couple also. We're not going to catch teams down, and that's probably the hardest adjustment our team is going to have to make.
Did you have a lot of fat ladies inviting you to operas during the summer?
We had a few. We were invited to a couple of operas, and I'm taking lessons myself.
And tonight, it is these young Golden State Warriors, whom you see sitting on the bench of Al Attles, who will take on the world champions as the NBA returns to CBS. And as you pan that bench, you will notice that gone, number 24, Rick Barry, their longtime superstar. Here's what Al Attles says about his new Warriors.
Well, obviously, when you lose a player of Rick's caliber, it takes a little while for a team that has depended on him for so long to gel. But I think we have some young players, and we'll try to play a little differently than we played when Rick was here. We'll like to try to play with a little bit more balance than we had in the past, and hopefully it will be the type of team that can play that way.
With a young team, a coach has got to have a little patience, too, right?
Well, I think if I have anything going for me, I think my biggest asset as a coach is patience. And I think that, of course, with this team, I think my patience will probably be tested.
Oakland Alameda County Coliseum in Oakland, California. It's the NBA on CBS. The world champion Washington Bullets and the Golden State Warriors. And a very good evening to everyone along the line. I'm Brent Musburger. A pleasure to be working with John Havlicek tonight. John, we got to be spending at least a quarter just introducing the Warriors to everybody.
Well, they certainly have a new team. I think that there are about 8 people out there with only 1 or 2 years of experience. So they're a very young club.
And, you know, the Bullets and Dick Motta are playing a pat hand. And as we asked Dick prior to the start of the contest, how do you stay on top? John Havlicek, your Celtics, the last team ever to repeat. Is it more difficult to stay at first?
Much more, because the easiest thing to do, Brent, is win a championship. The toughest thing is defend one. And I feel that anytime you're in that situation, as Dick Motta said, there will find no teams that are going to let down.
All right, John, and we've got the starting lineups now of tonight's ball game. And there in the center of the floor, you can see on your screen for the Bullets, the familiar five, Dandridge, Hayes, Unsell, Greavy, and Henderson. They're the five who eliminated Seattle in that brilliant 7-game series last May and June. And for the Warriors, well, it'll be a young team, as John Havlicek has indicated, and the key is going to be in the middle. Parrish and Ray, can they stay out of foul trouble? And 00, Robert Parrish will be jumping center. Yes, 3 officials in the NBA this year. Jake O'Donnell, the senior man, will throw it up. Bernie Fryer and Leroy Alexander will work alongside of him. And John and I will tell you what their roles are this year. The Bullets in their traveling blue as the Warriors break out a brand new uniform for this contest on CBS. Unsell, waiting for the cutter. Cross to Bobby D. Sonny Parker coming with him. Phil Smith on the double team, and John Lucas quickly to the interception. Lucas has the Warriors ahead.
Good play by John Lucas. I think he's leading the league in steals. Real good anticipation. They made a bad pass. He was in the lane picking it off.
The main man, John, to come from Houston to the Warriors as Rick Barry goes down to play for a whole lot of green. Now it's Unsell. Whistle blown by Jake O'Donnell. Sonny Parker's first foul, not Parrish. Sonny Parker picked up that foul. Here's Bobby D, wheel right. They try to keep the ball away from Hayes. It's the rookie, short, trying to do a number. Elvin on the turnaround on it. Greavy underneath, dishes inside, block shot. Here come the Warriors. Quickly to Phil Smith, he's a marvelous shooter.
The Warriors are a young team, so generally they're going to be a fast starter. Sometimes it may take a veteran team a little longer to get warmed up.
Hey, John, if the Warriors hit the boards tonight, they can get that running game going.
This is the thing. I think that if they stay out of foul trouble and hit the boards, they have people capable of running, and this can be a great asset to a young club.
Now, we've already had a couple of fouls called. That one's on the rookie Short from Jackson State. He's number 45. So two on the Warriors, and Hayes in and out. Bullets getting just one shot. Sonny Parker.
First three attempts have been running the ball up the floor, so I expect to see a lot of that from the young Warriors.
Unseld in low with Parrish. Greavy coming around to the baseline. Henderson, the perimeter. Bullets not penetrating right now. Lucas to the basket.
Very good move by Lucas. He's left-handed. He crossed over very well, and he's got great speed.
So the Warriors build a six-point lead. This was rated about a pick'em game. Maybe the champions would be favored by one, but it's tough on the road, particularly in the Pacific Division. Greavy inside. Short. And Short is off to Lucas. Watch his speed. And it hit Henderson's foot, so it'll go out of bounds to the Warriors.
We have John Lucas on the crossover dribble going to the hoop. The Bullets didn't get back. He went in for an easy layup.
Changed hands that time too, Hondo. Went to that right hand on that layup.
Yes, indeed.
Parrish comes out, and here's Lucas. Henderson will watch him. Sonny Parker off to a good start for Adels. He's missed a couple of shots here in the early going. Henderson runs the ball club for the champions. Unseld from the top of the circle. And the Bullets are just a little short right now. Lucas straight down.
He has that great ability to penetrate, and every time he does that, we have John Lucas penetrating the lane again. He's able to come in without anyone picking him up. 2 points.
And we've got a timeout, John. Dick Mata's got his champions over there. He's fallen down by 8 points, and Lucas has scored 3 field goals. When you're making the same point and he's coming with a replay, just keep right on talking. Let them put the replay in on top of you, and then you can drop back and double back on it. You don't have to stop and wait for that thing to lock up like you did on that last Lucas shot.
Okay.
We got a guy out here spinning basketballs. I'll tell you, he's putting on a show to my right. He's better than George.
Crazy George.
Terrific. How you doing in the truck?
Yes. Okay.
Keep it up now, because now, John, what we need now coming out of this commercial is for you to pick it up and just like say, you know, Brent, what the Bullets have got to do now to stem this. Why don't you just come in and give me a comment what they got to do, what they might have talked about, without me saying anything first. You just lay in right on top of me, okay?
I'm not going to talk about one person.
Oh man, Joey, how you doing? Catching it now, right? Pay those bills. Ooh.
I think what the Bullets have to do, particularly on offense, after they take the shot, they have their guards buried low, and Unseld's got the only man back, so their floor balance isn't real good at this time. So when those people come off the picks down low, they're going to have to either take the shot, and when they do, the other person is going to have to get back defensively.
They came up against pressure after that timeout, John. Greavy controlling. On the double team, Lucas switched over to the strong side, and it's a steal. It's 3-on-1. Dandridge frees the ball, and it's Lucas. He's all over the floor. Hayes has it knocked free, and Lucas is there. Back to Provis Short.
There's another example of that great team speed. They had a 3-on-1 break. The kids are really running, and they're putting the Bullets away early, but I expect this veteran team to come back.
of all the major sports, the one that features ebb and flow the most is the NBA. Oh, how these teams can put together streaks. But the champions now must dig in. They're back by 10 early. Dandridge coming in on Sonny Parker.
This is one of the things that Al Attles worries about. He has so many young players out there, the officials aren't used to them, and he thinks some of the calls that they get against them are not really fouls.
Grevy. Short. And the Bullets are not dominating. No offensive rebounds early. Phil Smith cut off. Grevy, William Hayes with a hand on it. Here's Robert Parrish. Short. Dandridge off quickly to Henderson. Lucas awaits him. Henderson pulls up on Lucas. Hayes couldn't tap it in, but he stuck with it. Still won't go. Nothing falling right for the champion. Unseld tried to draw the foul, and Parker burned him. A 12-point burst by the Warriors. Unseld's got Henderson free underneath.
John Lucas got hung up on that Wes Unseld pick, and he probably sets the best one in the league.
Unseld blocking Parrish. As you look at a final, the vastly improved New Jersey Nets 123, Cleveland 108. Bernard King, 34 points. Parker faces the hoop. Parrish. Hayes is off. When Parrish shoots outside, the Warriors don't have a lot of rebounding muscle underneath. Dandridge up over Parker.
The Warriors have shown that they can run the ball up the floor and get the fast break, but now they have to show us if they can work an offense, and I think this is where they really don't know each other very well yet.
Detroit 107, Kansas City 102. That's a final from Pontiac. Parker shoots three, Hayes comes over, and the foul is called.
We have Sonny Parker on a one-on-one move, coming into the basket, getting around his man, Elvin Hayes, fouling him, picking him up from the weak side. Good call.
So far, the Bullets are only 2 of 13 from the floor, and the Warriors 4 of 6. So after the Bullets score 4, Parker adds a free throw. 13-4. Steal by Parrish. Here's Lucas. It's 3-on-3. Lucas to the middle.
John Lucas can handle that middle probably as well as anyone in the NBA.
Former great out of Maryland, holds the scoring record at that school. Did it for Lefty Driesell. Dandridge outside. Up the iron. Smith's got a man open. It's Parker. Henderson's back. Sonny Parker.
With Bobby Dandridge taking the shot from the outside, and there was no one back. He went to the boards, and Sonny Parker took off for an easy layup.
Dandridge double team. Attles yelling defensive instructions. Grevy. Hayes tries to keep it alive. Unseld is off Hayes' hands. The pass was a bit high. Out of bounds to the Warriors.
Bullets kick. Elvin Hayes down low. Phil Smith picks him up. Ball goes out of bounds, and Elvin Hayes the last one to touch it. Yes. Right. Okay. Okay.
Take it, Doug. Coming out of commercial, John, pick it up and explain why the Warriors, the team concept, were able to get such a great start.
OK. Okay.
What they've done here. It's 2 of 14 and 8 of 13. So guys, you gotta watch.
Not yet.
Okay. You're missing a foul on Golden State.
Bring him out.
Two.
How many fouls on Golden State?
Right. Parker. It's three.
Three team fouls? Okay, who has it? I got Short and Parker.
The Warriors, they've really gotten off to a fast start, and I think it's due to the fact that they are a young team. It's a young season. And they've lost a couple of games that they thought they should have won. They definitely do not want to let this one get away from them tonight. The Bullets, on the other hand, are a little slow in their approach this first half or first quarter, and I think that, you know, after things get moving a little more, they'll turn it around.
And there's the main man for the Warriors so far tonight with 8 points, John Lucas. The Warriors have hit 8 of 13, and the Bullets only 2 of 15 with 5:50 to go, first quarter. Oakland. Parrish. They keep the pressure on.
Parker set a good pick that time on Wes Unseld, and he wasn't able to get around it because, and once he does get around it, then you have a situation where there's a mismatch.
Sonny Parker, Sonny Dandridge, who goes in behind, and he traveled. There's the man they're counting on here in Oakland, Robert Parrish, 00 out of Centenary. Joe Morgan of the Cincinnati Reds just sat down here at courtside. He's a big NBA fan. Doesn't miss a Warrior game. Here's the rookie, Short. Gets Hayes with a fake. Greedy. Lucas eyeing Henderson on defense, and here's E backing in on the rookie. Against the double team, and it's Hayes. And Wes Unseld underneath with control, and Al Addles now yelling instructions.
Parrish not blocking out Unseld, and if you don't do that, he's going to camp him there and get those easy layups. Elvin Hayes working the other side of the floor that time. He usually likes to set up on the left-hand side.
Final score, Phoenix on the road, 115. Chicago troubled at home, 110. 5-point victory by the Suns. Here's Greedy as the world champions are off to a slow start against the Warriors. Parrish with a marvelous pass to Phil Smith, who's fouled.
Same thing happened again that time. Greedy with the shot from the outside, followed the shot. Phil Smith was able to take off. A real good pass by Robert Parrish here. Phil Smith way out ahead of the pack, going in, draws the foul, good body control, easy layup.
That's 15 points for the two guards. Lucas and Smith, and John, those two guards are going to carry the scoring burden for this team.
No question about it. I think that
bad pass. Bullets are now turning sloppy also. Mata's got to have another timeout. So the world champions, who were blown out the other night in Seattle, will regroup around Dick Mata and Bernie Bickerstaff. They're down 26-6 in the first. Yeah, how about you, Sandy? Yeah, we got to get ready now. I'll tell you what the Bullets are got to do. They got to hit that bench.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, I'll tell you, that cup check has been awfully good. At the end of the quarter? Okay. They built a 20-point lead with their starters. And Al told me before the game, it's these dudes they're worried about. A They are fast.
They're going to get better, too. They're going to be real good.
That's a pretty good-looking little group over there, isn't it?
Mm.
Boy, do they keep the heat on. One. Wright's not with him, right?
No.
When Dick Motta goes to his bench and picks someone like Mitch Kupchak, this game could take on a different flavor. He's hit 61%, averaged 16 points a game. The bullets are deeper, and Al Attles is very concerned as Jake O'Donnell calls a foul. And you see Indiana's final margin over Denver, 112-99. The other night, George McGinnis went wild as Denver beat Phoenix at home. So here's the first Motta substitution. Charles Johnson replaces Tom Henderson. And there's a turnover. The ball will go to the Warriors. First period, Milwaukee 14, Seattle 11. CJ, of course, played on the championship team here for the Warriors in 1975 when they beat the Bullets in four straight for the title. Parrish traveled before he fired the shot. That is the first Golden State turnover in this game.
Anytime you're in a game like this and you're running and not turning it over, you're going to get good percentage shots, what they've done.
Lucas fighting Johnson to go right. The whistle is blown underneath.
Getting a little rough down there. Bobby D cut Sonny Parker in the face with an elbow.
So on the offensive foul, the ball is turned over to the Warriors. Smith controlling. Lucas is to his right. Here they are going through Lucas. He's the main man with the assist. And he's also had a hot shooting line.
Picks up at that point right opposite the foul line. No one picked him up as he came off, and he had a wide open jumper.
So they build it now, 28-6. And we watch the champions under pressure. They double team Hayes, and the whistle is blown.
That's usually where Alvin's most effective, on that side of the floor and that deep. If you give him that spot, he's going to hurt you.
Smith arguing that's his second foul. Two on Parker. Five team fouls on the Warriors and three on the Bullets. So the old bugaboo. Young, anxious, eager team here under Al Attles. Encountering his usual free throw shooting problems, but I can remember game seven when he hit a couple of big ones against the Sonics. Lucas with a quick move inside. CJ couldn't stay with him, John.
No, he couldn't. They cleared the left side and he started to go left, came back to the middle, and the defense didn't react properly.
Johnson right back with that baseline shot, and Parrish cleans it off. And the Warriors are playing determined basketball.
Short. A three-on-two situation there. A good shot. He just missed it. John Lucas responsible for getting it up quickly, and he's certainly doing it.
Unsell puts it down. Parker is off. Lucas again to the middle. Hits Bill Smith back outside. Unsell to Greavy. Dandridge is on his left. Dandridge with four. Elvin Hayes has not scored yet. Lucas. In by Sonny Parker.
Sonny Parker, a real good young player. Not being blocked off the board, and he can jump well. Good tap in.
Let's go up to Seattle right now and get a check in on Seattle, Milwaukee. Here's Don Cricky with an update. Paul's upset, and Bernie Fryer tells him to calm down. 32-8 and a minute 14 to go in the first quarter here in Oakland. Johnson around the screen. Parrish to the switch. Dandridge. So Dandridge hits a couple of field goals. He has 6 of the Bullets' 10 points. Grevy without a point. Hayes without a point. Johnson hasn't scored. Now Kupchak is there. Smith to the left hand, and the foul called as he came in.
Can they clear the left side that time for Smith? He's able to take Grevy on a one-on-one situation, go to the hoop, get the foul.
Two free throws for Phil Smith. Total of 8 points. Ian Lucas now with 21 of the Warriors' 34 points. Down to 30 seconds left. First period. Kupchak. Bang.
Mitch comes in. He's in about 10 seconds. Gets his first two. As you said, he's shooting well, over 61%. We also have Fegley in there against Phil Smith.
Quick shot by Lucas, a little too flat. First period coming to an end on CJ's shot. That's it. The end of the first period. It's 34-12 Warriors, and the NBA on CBS will return after these messages from your local stations. Where are we, Sandy?
Were they in Seattle? Did they
go to? I don't know what. I don't know where they are. Sandy? Sandy, do we have it back? The preceding announcement was brought to you as a public service by the National Basketball Association. We get ready to start the second period, and what a story we've got unfolding here in Oakland. Look at those first quarter statistics as the Warriors have blown out the world champions early. 34-12 right now. Look at the field goal percentages that those two teams shot.
Bullets 25, Warriors 60, and Al Adels, I know, is hoping that a lot of these people that are going to be coming into the game now are going to keep the hot hand going.
John, we've got a lot of lineup changes right now. I see that Parrish is still out there for Al Adels, but Nate Williams, the veteran, is there. Number 43, a rookie, Wayne Cooper from New Orleans. Welcome back to Oakland. You're watching a rookie by the name of Wayne Cooper hit for the Warriors as we start period number 2. 36-12. The world champion Washington Bullets trail the Warriors, who are trying to rebuild their franchise this year without Rick Barry. And they are doing it in one night.
Good agility for a big man. 7 feet tall, makes the steal, goes from one end of the floor to the other and lays it in.
Now the world champions are digging in with Unsell. Kupchak is out there. Roger Figley, the rookie, handling the ball from Figley. They've turned it over again to the Warriors. First, UCLA, the Bruins driving toward the Rose Bowl, leading Arizona by 2 touchdowns. Speaking of UCLA, here's Raymond Townsend handling the ball for the Warriors. Number 11, he's got it back. He's a rookie from the Bruins. Here's Phil Smith on the drive. Figley with it. Everything's going in for the Warriors. Hitting better than 60% against the champion.
Their defense is real good, too. They're holding up well. This is one thing that Al Addles was concerned about.
This is unbelievable. It's 40-12. Hayes on the follow away, and the whistle sounds. Phil Smith hit him.
You can't give Elvin that kind of position, or he's going to draw the foul or make an easy hoop.
Hayes coming to the line. And John Lucas checking back in. 8 of Al Addles' 12 players have only 2 years or less experience in the NBA. You take Hayes and Unsell and Dandridge up front, they got more experience than the whole Warrior team. Again. Loose ball foul against Kupchak.
Mitch getting a little anxious that time. Put a shoulder on the man in front of him. Foul.
So Hayes is now 0 for 4 from the free throw line. Nate Williams to John Lucas. Robert Parrish. Cooper. And here's Raymond Townsend. Now the Warriors can set up.
Is a streak shooter, and if he gets hot, he can really blow you up. They're looking for points from him coming off the bench, and he gave it to him immediately.
Hayes on the turnaround, in low, controlled by Cooper, off to Townsend, and here's Lucas, the young kids from Oakland. The pull-up is good by Lucas.
He's really got it going tonight. He can't do anything wrong. He plays with a lot of emotion. He can get the crowd up. He can get his teammates up. And he can pass it off, too. Great asset to have.
In that first period, Lucas with 12 points. Now a total of 14. This would be his first free throw. Out. Johnson, Kupchak, Fegley, Hayes, and Dandridge on the floor for Dick Motta. Deflected by Lucas. He thought he had a steal. Timeout has been called. Al Addles, and look at the champions bench. They're gazing at the scoreboard and they can't believe it either. It's 44-12. Hey, Sandy, this is the most entertaining blowout I've ever seen. Oh, tell them to cut it out, will you? They got the champions down here under pressure. Yeah. Huh? Hey, my man, huh? Everybody wants to see the champions get pounded. Hey. I'm getting the heat now. Franklin has lined up this guy right in front of me to lecture me. Franklin's right here to my right. We've got Sandy. You've got him right. He never gets his coat back. Okay, that's the word to Franklin.
Are we going to, are we going to be doing anything?
This is a joke.
All right.
I wouldn't watch this either.
Are we going to do commentary?
Yeah.
All right, Clipper!
Let's go!
There is the happiest man in the San Francisco Bay Area right now, Franklin Muley. the owner of the Golden State Warriors. They lead the Bullets 44-12. Now the champions try to dig in and start one of those streaks which can occur so rapidly in the NBA. Charles Johnson from outside.
You
watch them go to work, Havlo, because they're going to come.
On the double team that time, they found the open man. CJ drilled it.
Cooper looking in. Offensive foul. Now quickly the Bullets can put together two field goals.
Good
defense. The trouble Lakers tied with the Clippers at the half. The Clippers beat the Lakers the other night. Los Angeles could score only 1 point the last 3 minutes and 54 seconds. Here's Kupchak. He throws it up. Not there. Deflected now and controlled by the Warriors. Lucas is in the middle. It's 3-on-2 to the Indians. Goaltending. Kupchak came over. Jake O'Donnell picked it up.
We have the Warriors coming out on a fast break again. Lucas leading it, hitting the wingman, goaltending on the play. 2 points. Again, they had a 4-on-2 situation.
7 assists by Lucas so far. Chases the man. Johnson, too much spin that time. Dandridge coming down with Williams, and Bobby Dandridge with the loose ball foul.
Good rebound by Nate Williams. He had the man on his back. Bobby D went over him. First thing you have to do is box that man out.
Lucas and Townsend bring it up for Adels. Clifford Ray. He's in the middle now. Elvin Hayes with a hand on him. They've eliminated hand checking this year in the NBA. The game flows freely without it, doesn't it? Raymond Townsend. Now we've got another game working, you know. Seattle-Milwaukee. And we're going to stay right with the action here in Oakland. And as soon as the Bullets get a streak going, we're going to bring you right back. But let's send you up to Seattle and Don Quickie for an update on that action. Lucas with the score 48-16. Greg Ballard will soon check in. Townsend spins out. Loose ball foul. Cooper came up over Kupchak's back, John.
Good job by Kupchak that time. Again, he had the man on his back. And here again, this is what the rookies have to learn. They can't go over people's back. In college, they're sometimes a little larger than the people they play, but it's pretty tough to go over a man like Kupchak.
Fegley. Deflected off Ballard's hand. He saves it. Comes up. Out of bounds. It'll go to the Warriors. CJ giving it to his former boss. Ball.
Good anticipation by CJ that time because he got Lucas in a situation where he couldn't do anything with it and he traveled.
Hey, John, the whistles now are starting to go in the Bullets' favor. Have you noticed?
That has happened a little bit. Maybe they're trying to get them back into the game.
Ballard was fouled. Nate Williams picks up the personal. Number 33 saying, what'd I do, Jake? Come on, man.
They have to move the ball a little more. They're not really moving the ball well. They're pounding it. They have to move it with quick passing.
So you can see he's been tough at that free throw line. Missed only one this season. 9 of 10.
Hit some crucial free throws last year in the playoffs and gave them a lift numerous times. Good young player.
Wes Unseld watching. Cooper. Johnson to the rebound for the Bullets. They trail it 48-18.
By Mitch. He's one of the only people 6'10 that'll really go after a ball like someone 5'9. He gets on the floor a lot and he comes up with a lot of great defensive plays.
Bullets will have to stop that break and be patient down here on offense, John, if they're going to climb back in.
They have to get a streak going. It'd be good if they could get a couple of fast breaks, but they do have to be patient on offense. There's still a long way to go.
Check looks for the man open, and it's Roger Fegley, the rookie. Kupchak. To 20, and ever so slowly, you can sense the champions are about to put together a run.
There's a totally different lineup in there right now, trying to get something started. The only starter is Elvin.
Williams. It back, turns around on Ray. So now if the Bullets can tighten up and take away this long rainbow from Nate Williams, might put together two or three in a row. Here's Lucas. Warriors run the shot clock down inside of five. Clifford Ray call when he's set up down there, taking the spot away. And there's going to be a timeout here in Oakland, California. As the Warriors go over to huddle around Al Attles, who has put together a brand new look with this team, playing without Rick Barry, it is 50-22. Still hitting only 10 of 34. Isn't that amazing? I'll tell you, you know what, Sandy? The guy spinning the balls right in front of me is pretty good. That'll be the last time I'm picking up the tab when they take down. I'll tell you that. I mean, that's it. You guys are unbelievable. What's that?
You missed it.
You missed it. That's it, baby.
You missed the real green.
Try to watch the man here. He's still no hand check.
He's doing it. So here they come, the world champions, with Henderson, Fegley, Ballard, Kupchak, and Hayes, and right now they are the perplexed world champions. They trail the young Warriors 50-22 with 5 minutes and 16 seconds to go in the first half. Henderson's double team to the baseline. 3 second violation. On the turnover. Here they come. Now Attles Warriors. Henderson is picking up Lucas at the midcourt line now, trying to keep him outside. He's not been penetrating as much lately. Hayes is off. Ballard inside now, and Kupchak. 50-24. Here they come. Robert Parrish is going to check back in for Attles.
John Lucas, just a great shot that time. He got a step on his man, used the board from a very difficult angle. Tough shot.
No basket.
I think you'll probably see more of that call this year because of the three officials.
Without the hand checking, John, and with the 3-second violation called a little more closely, that middle could open up.
And Lucas is finding it open too.
Offensive foul. As it came into Parrish, he threw an elbow.
We have Parrish down low, getting a little heat from Kupchak. Backs him off with a little elbow.
Hayes. Nate Williams with authority. Lucas quickly off to Townsend. Pull up.
Just great speed and penetration by Lucas. He's making this offense really go. He's responsible for about 80% of it right now.
Bullets trailing by 30 points. Turn it over. Off to Lucas.
Bad pass at the other end that time, trying to throw it right across the middle. A lot of hands in there.
Lucas in a foot race with Fegley.
The steal. John Lucas has a free rein to the basket. Puts it up, 2 points. Great anticipation, good defense. Blowout. All four wheels, five wheels. This can really get them going. They got to learn how to win on the road, though.
Yeah, that's right, young team. Look at the turnovers. Look at what they've done to them.
Five straight.
Yeah, okay. Another win to 1-4.
1-4 now.
Okay. 1-4. Okay, going to 1-4. All right, let's go now. Stay down. Stay. You got a minute. You got a minute.
I'm sorry, what'd you say?
Okay, now. Before
no,
you
I didn't.
Can run, you
have
to
stand there.
Okay. If you rebound first, everybody's got to make sure we get the lanes covered. Get all the lanes covered. It doesn't matter. Take it up inside. Okay, now. No fouls. Really play defense from here on out.
Come on, down.
The 8-24 with 3 minutes left in the first half in Oakland. The turnover 16-5. And the Bullets also have been equally cold. Off of Ray, Henderson runs it down for Mata. Ballard. On the block. Here's Henderson lead to Ballard. Williams with him and Ballard hit the layup.
A little foul on that play too. He probably thought he might be able to get a 3-point play.
They pulled back to within 30, John.
Parrish. that's what they have to do, get some shots inside, maybe pick up some fouls, and if they can do that, maybe they can creep back into it.
Here's Cooper. From New Orleans. Anderson picks up Lucas. We're down to a minute 30 left in the first half. Cooper. Anderson fouled and injured as he came inside. Trainer John Lally rushing out. Second injury timeout. Townsend checking with Adels and Tommy Henderson to the free throw line.
Really fun basketball for the Warriors. They're just running, flowing free. Lucas has everyone charged up, hits the open man, so everyone's going to get involved.
And down to a minute 10. Have turned it over 17 times.
You can't win many ball games with that many turnovers. Once you start getting up to 20 and they already have 17 in the first half, you're in real trouble.
Hayes and Ray. Loose ball foul call on Elvin.
Elvin getting a little frustrated, going to the board, trying to go over someone's back. Good call by the official.
I'll tell you, the three officials and the no hand checking, I think the game has really opened it up. Of course, it may be just watching these young Warriors.
I think it's something that's been needed for a long time.
Here's Fegley. And that should allow the team to get to the end of the first half. Unbelievable first half. 58-34. Golden State leads Washington.
Washington has one more game left on this Western swing, and if they lose this one tonight, I'm sure they expected to do a lot better.
Set the scene, and it will be a countdown into a commercial, right?
Hey,
is going to be a gangbuster second half.
How do you pronounce that?
Ophir Prison Marching Kazoo Band. Havlicek's going to sing with this band. Havlicek, get in that bullet locker room and kick some ass. Kupchak off the bench leads the Bullets. Yeah.
Think he'll probably do a little chewing at halftime.
Oh, he'll be raving in there. He's got the door locked right now. Hey, Sandy, can the minicam pick up the visitors' locker room outside? Give me a shot of that door.
Look at this one.
Okay. Back in Oakland, I'm Brent Musburger with John Havlicek, and let me tell you, the fat lady's got laryngitis tonight. I can't believe what's happening to the champions. Lucas with 18, Smith with 11. The Bullets have turned the ball over 17 times in the first half. It's incredible. That card on Israel that he had. Coming right back to that lead, Chuck. Okay.
It off now.
They'll start throwing their clothes up. Championship, and that series went the distance. And the benefit for the Bullets, well, they were something special. Anything you want, big guy. I want to do it. Then what are we going to do? Let's find out who these guys are. Let's talk about these Bullets. Who are these guys, Hondo? Where they come from? The Warriors.
University of New Orleans.
Huh? Look at these guys. I mean, I never heard of them. Second year, fourth year, first year. Ricky Green's gone. They played three rookies in that first half.
Yeah.
There's smoke coming out of Dick Motta's locker room right now. Who are these guys? Yeah. Station break. I'm not sure where he's going after the division. You said to run through the divisions. You said to run through the divisions. Okay, and then where do we go? Okay. Well, what's the order of the divisions? I don't care. You put them up however you want.
They win tonight?
Yeah. They're the first team to win five games. That's something? First team to win five games.
New Atlanta. I think they'll be better than Atlanta was, though.
What's wrong with these guys?
No D. Giving up 118 a game. 115.
Thank you.
wonder, of those turnovers, how many of them have been direct steals?
I don't know. That'd be a good question. Oh, I love the duck. Here in Oakland, Granny Duck can't believe it. 58-34. Her Warriors are blowing out the world champions. And what a year in transition this is going to be for the NBA. You can just feel it as you take a look at the Eastern Conference standings. In the Atlantic Division, of course, Washington has switched over, and the New Jersey Nets are the first team to win five games as they go to 5-4. Philadelphia now, of course, playing without George McGinnis. And in the Central Division, over there where Rick Barry is holding court with Houston, they're off to a blazing start. And how nice it is to see Rudy Tomjanovich back on the floor playing so well for the Rockets. Cleveland starts strong. San Antonio, New Orleans, Atlanta, Detroit has moved there from the Midwest. They are off to a slow start. Now in the Midwest, Denver, where McGinnis is, they lead. Indiana, Kansas City, Milwaukee, and Chicago lost again tonight, so they have slipped to 1-6. And in the Pacific, a year ago, they were by far the toughest division in the NBA. Now they are perhaps the biggest question mark. The Portland Trailblazers at 2-4, and everybody wondering what's going to happen to Bill Walton. The word is, regardless of where he winds up, he will not play until next February. The Trailblazers are still hoping that the big redhead will be back on the floor for them.
Did I hold the cards up right?
Now, disconnect the cable that runs up to Seattle. And let's get on with this.
So I have to come out with the unknown defense.
The unknown basketball.
The white uniforms are acting as the green Notre Dame jerseys.
That's right, it's the white uniforms. That's indeed, that's what it is. Havlicek's got it. Hondo's line. Give Hondo a white uniform. The Washington bench, Mata. Back
stuck in Oakland and perplexed Washington trying to put it together. They're still talking. Coach Dick Motta huddling with Elvin Hayes. And just listen to Hayes' line. He was 1 of 8 in the first half. 0 of 4 from the free throw line. Couple of turnovers. What do you think the significance and the key to this game has been so far, Hondo?
Well, it's the fact that the Warriors got off to a real good start. They're running very well. Washington came down the floor, took some outside shots, followed the ball. They did not have good floor balance, and I think they probably have 25 points on fast break layups. The Washington Bullets are going to have to come up with an unknown defense or something to get back in this game.
What about that good luck charm the Warriors have got going tonight?
That's a new one. They got their new white uniform, so maybe they're acting as the Notre Dame green jerseys or something, but they're really putting it all together tonight. They'll never want to take the white off. They'll even want to wear them on the road.
That's right. They'll ask everybody, let us wear the white. There's Sonny Parker. Who are these guys anyhow? Lucas, Smith, Short, Parker, Parrish, and the world champions are going to have to go hand to hand now. Unseld, Henderson, Greavy, and Dandridge, and Hayes are out there. Going to have to get Elvin involved in the offense. Unseld knocks it away from Parrish, out of bounds. Warriors will keep it. Well, the Bruins continue to roll over the Wildcats down in the Los Angeles Coliseum. The Bruins were favored by 13, and it's all going to come down to UCLA and USC for the Pac-10 championship and a trip to the Rose Bowl. Now Lucas checks the shot clock inside of 5. Puts one up left-handed, almost made it. Hayes is off. Here's Henderson, remember, 58-34 on the steal. Another turnover, number 18 for the Bullets. Back to Parker, 3-on-2. They wasted too much time to shoot there.
That time it was very evident. Lucas couldn't get to the middle, and you had a man who was unfamiliar with that spot, and the fast break really didn't look that well. If Lucas had been there, I'm sure it would have come off much faster.
Smith picked up Greedy high. They get the ball to Unseld. Parrish gives him room. They'd like West to take more shots. Here's Henderson. Hayes off. Run down the corner by Smith and a loose ball foul against Kevin Greedy, who was coming over on him.
And again. Again, we have San Diego leading the Lakers 87-86 in the fourth period. I believe they've beaten them once. This could be the second time they've played their last three games against each other.
That game down in the fourth. Jerry West beside himself the other night when the team went cold in San Diego. Mitch Kupchak, Dick Motta holding his head. He may leave this one early. Smith hits the free throw. Kupchak was the high man for the Bullets in that first half, coming off the bench to score 10 points. Greavy.
Here comes John Lucas pushing it up fast. He's back down the floor before some of the defense.
Out of bounds, they turn it over to the Bullets. Now the Warriors can't get sloppy. Comes up on Lucas and goes to Hayes. Drops it back to Tommy inside and two quick hoops.
They have to get inside a little more. The last two times or three times down the floor, they've been outside twice. That time they got in for a much easier hoop.
And the Bullet defense, John, is starting to force the Warriors out away from the basket.
They're picking up much higher. And if you do that, it's going to make the offense much tougher to run from various angles.
Balance underhand, throws in the layup.
Just a great individual effort there. Great body control. Sonny Parker has a great future. I think he can swing for this team. They're going to be able to do that with him. And with the 11-man roster, that's so important to have swing there.
Dandridge puts it up. Short.
Again, another perimeter shot, and here they come.
Milwaukee, Seattle are tied. And Smith.
That time they had a 4-on-2 fast break, and this is easy basketball to play. When you get people up the floor, everyone running, you really don't have to get into a real strenuous game.
So the Bullets must start to hit to take away that break. Dandridge is off, and here they come again, looking for the outlet. It's Smith pushing it. Henderson cuts him off. Purvis short. And Sonny Parker out with an offensive rebound. Shot clock goes down inside of 10. Parrish puts it to the floor, and here's Short. Oh. The kids are shooting with confidence now. To the corner, runs it down.
I think he was a little intimidated by Elvin that time. Anytime you have Elvin chasing you, you know you can get up and block your shot.
I just stole the ball from Elvin Hayes, and I'm only a rookie. I don't believe it. Here's Henderson up on Lucas. Short again. Elvin back in for the rebound. Too much spin. Off the Warriors, though. Timeout has been called. 8 minutes and 26 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Al Addles trying to make a team out of his youngsters, and he's getting done tonight, isn't he?
Elvin really missed Unseld underneath that time. Both men came at him. Just should have dumped it off. All right.
You know how I love it. Yeah, all right. Sure.
What's the game?
What's the score up there?
It's a dull defensive game. Both teams missing a lot of shots. We got a team with 68 points with 8:26 to go in the third. That's right. For the moment, no question about this game. Milwaukee and Seattle are seesawing, so let's go up to Don Cricky for a report. Bullets inbound. Here's Henderson. Hayes inside on the turnaround. There's his shot.
That's his shot once you get it down there, and I'm sure that the Warriors are going to put four men at him. He's going to have to pick out the open man if he starts to miss those.
Parker. Looks good, doesn't he?
Good quick move. He really had the defense back on its heels and took the shot.
So they stay up by 15 field goals, a 30-point difference. Dandridge left alone. Warriors didn't want the foul.
On a mismatch that time, down low with Lucas.
20 seconds left on the shot clock when the Warriors got the ball up to the attack zone after a basket. They just apply white lightning. Smith. Bullets now at 19, Greedy to the shot. And there's Hayes. Stay taps it up left-handed, still battling. Won't go in. The frustrations of the world champions continue to mount. Sliding inside, slap.
We have Elvin Hayes getting positioned underneath. Puts it up one time. Good second effort here. He can't get it. They keep battling away. It's one of those nights for Elvin. He just can't get the ball in the hole.
And John at the other end picked up the foul. Unseld now upset about that call by the rookie referee. Still yelling at him. Purvis Short looks in on Hayes. Smith hits Parker on the cut.
Movement without the ball. He didn't give up. He just kept moving until he got a position where he could receive the ball. Good shot, good movement.
Greedy open and missed. Parker dribbles around Henderson. Into the middle, and here's Smith. Comes up on Hayes with a left-handed shot. Unseld. Out to Dandridge. Two on two. Away from Greedy. Couldn't control it quickly enough. And here's Dandridge. Unseld now. Into the inside, and Henderson. Unseld taps it in.
Good pass by West that time. He followed the shot, was able to tip it in.
6 minutes and 11 seconds to go in the third. Hayes has switched on Smith. Parker to the screen, and Dandridge goes to Phil. Parrish rolls a hook shot. Control Hayes, off Henderson. Two men back in white. Dandridge down the baseline. Sonny Parker, John, handles the ball a lot for a forward.
Yes, he does. He's played a lot of guard also, and that's enabled him to become a pretty good ball handler.
Parrish coming out, and Wes Unseld using the hip. Elvis against Parrish. Offense.
We have Parrish receiving the ball, trying to make a move on Wes, leading with an elbow. He and Wes have gotten something going down there.
And the key stat there, Robert Parrish with three fouls right now. 5 minutes and 21 seconds to go in the third. We've got a timeout. Yeah, that's what I figured. It was okay just to get out, right?
Okay.
I think that has Ray got any fouls? He's got one. Pick up the fourth foul on Parrish.
How many on Parrish? Three on Parrish, right?
If they could run out of about 56, make it 72-56.
One on Ray. One on Ray.
Anybody got Hayes has got three and Greavy. Well, I think Greavy's played a terrible game.
Anyone else
have
He's not been in it.
Bullets have hit 20 of 59, make it 20 of 60 on that miss by Dandridge. Greavy with only one field goal in the first period misses again. 20 of 61 right now. Lucas cut off and just came up with a left-handed shot. Curtis Short.
Curtis Short getting inside. No one checked him off the boards, and he can get up. Rookie's getting a lot of valuable experience early in the season.
Addles telling to slow it up, set the play. Foul called as Parker began his move.
John Lucas driving down the center, taking the shot. Misses. Purvis Short not being checked off, tipping it up nicely and in.
Dandridge assessed that personal. Phil Smith brings Parker down on the weak side. Smith swings to the ball side. Parrish.
He's 7 feet tall, and he puts enough arch on it so no one would ever get it.
Golden State Warriors in by far their best performance of the season to date. Pull up Henderson. Unseld, taken away. Purvis Short's three on one. Here's Parrish.
Again, we don't have the bullets getting back. Purvis Short leading the middle to Robert Parrish. Slam dunk.
Kupchak will report. Dandridge to the spin.
everything the Bullets get seem to be a perimeter shot. They have to get inside a little more. This is where they can get them into a little foul trouble.
Warriors hit a rhythm early, and they've not gotten out of it. And when you get a young team going like this, they can go all night. Taken away by Greedy. Sloppy pass by Smith. Here's Henderson. Two on one. Hayes to his right, and Elvin will crash through. You keep waiting for the champions to regroup and run a string, and the Warriors will come right down and respond with a hoop.
They're keeping the pressure on.
This team has not backed off. And with the Pacific wide open, John, they could get a lot better as the season progresses.
There's no question about that. They really don't know each other that well because they're so young, and I'm sure that they're going to get better and better.
Brady on the move in off of Smith's hand, tapped up and in by Hayes. Pretty move.
Elvin coming to life a little bit here in the third quarter.
Now maybe you wonder. But again, like I said, every challenge has been answered by the men in white. Lucas spinning one up. Stays with it. Smith is over there. The Bullets not blocking out.
Can't afford to give them that many shots down low.
Mata is going to go to his kids. Kupchak, Ballard, and Fegley will be coming in. It's good night veterans for the Bullets. They couldn't do it here in Golden State. Hayes. Total of 8 points for Hayes here in the second half. Give him 10 now for the game. Hayes with 8 points in the third quarter. 1:46 to go in the third. Smith. The youngsters are walking back to the Bullet bench right now. So we're going to have a break. Timeout in Oakland. Would you believe it? Mata. And the Bullets trail at 80-54. It's fun to watch a team flow like that. I love basketball, you know?
Reminds me of like 72-3 when we had that young team.
Yeah.
Just run.
All
run.
Right. Look at those. Look at Lucas over
there.
Yeah,
he's standing up.
Huh? Smith, Parker. Like antelope, this team.
Yeah. It's like Auerbach. Never let anyone sit
Unsell,
or a,
just looked over
timeout.
At Hayes and says, who the hell are these guys?
Nice, Jake. Hey, Jake, who designed your new warm-up jacket?
Huh?
Who designed your new warm-up jacket?
We're back in Oakland with 1:41 to go in the third quarter. And Jake O'Donnell just telling John Havlicek that he thinks the design on the new official's jacket is lousy. All right, here comes Henderson to the attack for the Bullets. He's out there with Roger Fegley, Bobby Dandridge, Mitch Kupchak, and Greg Ballard. And Ballard's not moving at all. Here's Henderson. Spun out.
Again, another perimeter shot. They can't get inside.
Lucas running down the time. 1:15 in the third. The Warriors can be expected to take the air out of the ball somewhat. Smith is short. Dandridge to Henderson. Sloppy on the turnover again, making it 20 turnovers for the Bullets.
Here's where the Warriors can get some valuable experience in running their offense. Good pick down low. No one picked up Smith coming across the center.
Dandridge.
I think Kamada wants to leave Bobby in there a while because he missed a lot of training camp and he's really not in real good shape yet, so he's going to get in shape tonight.
Well, the Warriors are getting there if they keep the pressure on. Boy, they've been moving up and down the floor. Unseld and Hayes are happy for the break over there. Lucas threw it up at the buzzer. Ballard to Henderson, who's all alone. That's one of the few huge defensive mistakes that Al Addo's team has made. And it came just as the buzzer goes off, ending the third period. So we've got 12 minutes to go. 82 to 58. The Bullets can still make one move.
They cut it to 24.
Here it comes. This is it. One move. This is coming right now. It's coming. I'm telling you, guy. I'm telling you. Tell them to give it back for this fourth quarter. They're going to see something.
They cut it to 24.
I think it's down to 24. We've whittled 6 points off that lead. Tel Aviv. That's right.
They got beat over there, too.
Tommy Abernathy will report in.
Where's Epps? I see Ray Epps.
Ray Epps. He'll be here. Charlie, how'd that fish sit with you? So done. I ate too much bread. I think the Bullets ate too much too. Yeah, my man.
Not bread though.
Huh? You want the sign? She ain't gonna be singing tonight, folks. It's the 11 minutes and 55 seconds, and the Bullets have got to get fully whittled away at it, though, haven't they, John?
Well, they've cut it to 24, and that time the Warriors picked him up full court to start the fourth quarter.
Not gonna give him any daylight. Dandridge at 5 seconds forces one, and Lucas has got Parker
again. The guards being caught inside, no one back on defense. It's happened too many times.
There's the third quarter stats. The Warriors continue to blaze away. And they've broken even with them rebounding tonight. Fegley traveled, made the extra move as he came to the dribble. 21 turnovers, Washington, 9 for Golden State. Lucas will go out and play a couple of sets of tennis. That's how fresh he looks right now. Abernathy.
Good move by Abernathy. That used to be an old Rick Barry play. He worked that on me a few times.
What is it, back to 28, John? Fegley. So the rookie from Bradley will get some shooting time here. Phil Smith to the dribble, turn around on Fegley. Fegley cut off Smith, brings dribble left side. Ballard back on the right. Everybody's on the strong side. Now Dandridge goes away from the ball. Ballard comes across. Fegley, CJ, outside perimeter shot. Hayes to check back in for the Bullets. Off Smith hands out of bounds.
They set that play up real well. John Lucas making an excellent pass. Phil Smith just having a little trouble holding.
Elvin Hayes reports in. We get a timeout. And when you come back, John Havlicek's going to talk to us about Ray Epps.
Ray Epps, Norfolk State.
Number 32.
Passed up his senior year to turn pro. Entered the pros, first year spent it on injured reserve.
We want the Ray Epps story from Hondo. He's number 32. No, he's in white. He's in white. He's getting ready to check in. Raymond Townsend to the attack.
From Bobby Dandridge School, right?
Yes, Norfolk State. That's right. Yes. Okay, Hondo, tell me about Epps.
Ray Epps came out of Norfolk State, did not play his senior year there, led the team in scoring, spent his first year on injured reserve, and hoping to get into this ball game tonight from the same school as Bobby Dandridge.
Norfolk State with two NBA players, Sonny Parker, Purvis Short, Clifford Ray with his warm-up off, so he's coming back. And we get the Prince out here, putting on a little showtime out here. There you are.
Clifford Ray, the elder statesman, with 7 years in the NBA of the Golden State Warriors.
I don't know, but Dick Motta's motioning to this guy. I don't know what Motta wants. What band is that we've got entertaining the folks here tonight?
We have the Ophir Prison Marching Kazoo Band and Temperance Society Limited.
Nice uniforms.
Directed by Captain Rufus T. Whizbang.
Nine minutes and 49 seconds left. There's the captain. Raymond Townsend on the floor with John Lucas. Elvin Hayes in the cup check. Cup check on the turnaround is way short. Missed everything. Off Hayes, out of bounds to the Warriors.
We have Clifford Ray and Parrish in at the same time, so they're adding a lot of muscle to combat cup check and Hayes.
Free steak dinners in Oakland whenever the Warriors score 150 points. Here's Townsend. Hayes. Take him in the strongman competition. Johnson off of Fegley now quickly, and Townsend on defense. Cup check. Loose ball. The battle won by Fegley. Cup check is there. Batted out of bounds, but let's keep it. One thing about Cliff Ray, you always know when he's coming. Outside of Al Addles, he's got the most booming voice in the NBA. Quick shot, Fegley.
He used the pick very nicely that time. He took his man right into it. A lot of people take their man around the pick, and he used it very effectively.
From Lucas, who raises his hands in triumph, and Robert comes back down.
Great perception by Lucas. The defense had its back turned. He threw it up to Robert Parrish. Slam dunk. Good vision.
The Lakers are making no mistake, they're not about to ease off. Ray and Parrish on the floor together. Battle's just adding pressure at the rebounding end. Abernathy crashes with Ballard. And the floor survives. Tommy Abernathy, formerly of the Lakers, out of Indiana. Lucas from Maryland. Townsend, UCLA. There's some thoroughbreds on this team. And they're playing like antelope tonight, aren't they, Hondo?
They're running, 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 and I'm sure that they're going to be running at the end of the season. They're just gaining a little confidence tonight.
Hayes and Parrish poleaxed him as he turned around. I mean, he took the hammer to him that time.
We have Hayes down low with Ray guarding him. Parrish coming from the top side. Elvin didn't see him, and no way, Elvin.
So Hayes gets a rematch at the free throw line. He's 0-4. Ah, 1-5. Hayes spins one in. 90-67 at 7:14. There's fire in Elvin's eyes. Lucas.
What a move by Kupchak.
Welcome back to Oakland, 90-69. The young Golden State keeping up the pressure. Mitch Kupchak has been furious up and down the court the last couple of times, trying desperately to get the bullets back in it along with Elvin Hayes. Here they come. They are now in the process of putting together their best run of the night. Can they keep it going? Hayes with a strong baseline move. Now it's 90-71. 6 minutes and 29 seconds to go. Bickerstaff and Mata, both on their feet right now. They can feel momentum changing, and Al Attles, meanwhile, wants timeout. John Havlicek, what a job Attles' young team has done here so far tonight.
They certainly have. They've been playing real good defense, and this is what has triggered the fast break that's been so effective for them. And anytime you play the good defense, you're going to be in a ball game. That's been his main concern. They've averaged 112 a game, but they've given up 113, so I think that he's going to be very pleased with this effort tonight.
All right, we're going to keep an eye on this action right here in Oakland. Al Attles checking that time. And while we do that, let's send you right back up to Seattle and Don Quickie. John Lucas had scored 18 points in the first half and was scoreless as we hit the 6:23 mark. So they got to get him back into the flow. They've taken him out of the offense. There are the Warriors waiting for the timeout to end. It's all going to be guts and determination, Hondo, at that other end.
That's right.
No other way. And that play by Kupchak was the key.
These guys can't play the clock now either.
So here they come. It's Hayes, Ballard, Fegley, Kupchak and Johnson. And Mata thinks he's got a chance. He was going to put young Dave Corzine in, and he brought him back to the bench. When they put together the three field goals, he said, I'm going to give it one last try at 6:23. Now, Adels is up because he does not want a brush fire to turn into a blaze. Hayes jumps out. Call for the foul. One team foul apiece, so the Warriors take it out of bounds. And that's four fouls on Elvin.
Warriors have to keep playing the same kind of ball that they played for three and a half quarters. Push it up the floor, put the pressure on.
Raymond Townsend. All over Kupchak, he was fouled by two Warriors. It's just a question of which one gets the foul. And it's going to be against Cooper, number 43.
John Lucas not in there right now, so this takes away some of the direction offensively.
A young team can also get a little eager and over-anxious when you put heat on them. Three of them crashing that time. Hayes with too much spin. Abernathy to control it. Cross court now to Smith. Townsend and Smith working in Al Addo's backcourt. Clifford Ray on the ball side to pick. Johnson keeps hand contact. Smith comes around and Hayes switches. Short, but Clifford Ray runs it down. Smith again moves inside of Hayes. Ballard to defend him, but it's right to Cooper. Bullets gave him three shots that time. Five minutes and 20 seconds. Ballard. Foul called as the pass comes into high. Hayes, it's against Ray.
Elvin Hayes getting that position down there a little better right now. Parrish not being in the game has taken away some of the rebounding that the Warriors have.
Here's young Greg Ballard. Charles Johnson quickly to the shot is short. Ballard has it to Smith, and the Warriors come up Townsend. Kupchak back. Little Smith, Fegley there on him. Smith moves to the baseline neatly.
Phil Smith loves shooting at the baseline, from the baseline.
Cooper is working on Kupchak. Inside to Johnson. Good pass to Ballard. Stolen Warriors, Abernathy.
Good collapsing defense that time.
Los Angeles wins, beating San Diego. And here's Dave Corzine.
And Ray Epps also checks in.
So we welcome Ray Epps out of Norfolk State. He will take Ballard. Fegley. Cooper rebounds to Smith. Townsend.
Raymond Townsend playing with a lot of poise for a rookie. Good ball player.
3:45, and here's CJ. Off Ray, bullets control.
Clifford hadn't found the handle the last three times he's touched the ball.
Smith steals. Almost traveled and held it in time. Those bonkers.
That's where Clifford was so effective with Rick Barry on the pick and roll.
Fegley.
Clifford Ray setting a pick for Phil Smith, and this is one of the things that he did so well with Rick Barry. Gets the man leaning defensively. Good pass by Smith. Slammed up.
Now we go. On the plate.
3:10 now.
Townsend. Ballard. Here's Kupchak. Begley. Corzine. Somebody sent for Don Meredith so he can sing the song, folks. This one's all over.
Phil Smith made a great play that time. He ran from one end of the baseline to the other to get involved in that offensive play, made the shot. Good hustle.
Begley with a pretty play at the other end.
Isn't Begley using great body balance on that move?
Look out. Somebody got kicked over there. Spectator, I believe, got hurt. And Epps, too. Both of them are injured. Dickie D'Oliva checking the fan, who's right behind Epps. Everybody cheers and looks the other way. How about that other guy? Oh, it's a little girl. Dickie D'Oliva's right there. Ballard. Ray charges Begley.
We have Raymond Townsend's on the feed to Clifford Ray. Good position by Fegley. Ray taking it to him a little bit. Good play by Fegley.
This party's over. Let's go to the bank and collect. The Golden State Warriors have erupted tonight in Oakland. Johnson goes to Fegley. Oh, look at that. They're at the century mark in Oakland. Cooper. Having it. Johnson. Loose ball. One. He stepped out of bounds. Are they yelling about? They want blood here tonight.
They want blood. They don't want to give them anything.
Corzine. Fouled by Cooper. 117. Nothing like a good home-cooked meal in the NBA, Hondo.
Oh, man.
And the Bullets want to get back to Dukes.
We only scored 100 points. Seems like 150.
Zeps. Short of everything. Just about missed the arena. Begley. Oh my, Cooper with authority. I'm running out. And the Bullets will be quite pleased when this one comes to an end. I wonder how it feels for a world champion to be a sacrificial lamb when you start to turn a young team like this around, Jack.
I can remember being down to Seattle, an expansion team, after we'd won a championship one year, 77-33 at halftime. It's not a good feeling. It's easy to forget this one.
Let's see, they've only got 75 games to forget it, right? The regular season. From
this one will get washed away with a quick shower and a trip to their favorite restaurant and a little good Italian food, some mighty San Francisco bread. We would like to credit Chuck Milton, our producer, and Sandy Grossman, our director, for presenting us with this marvelously close contest. We've got 10 seconds. Seriously, they did their usual fine job. Down to the last five. Well, John, 102-83, and what can you say about that?
I think that the Bullets are going to forget about it. It's a great confidence builder for the Warriors. John Lucas orchestrating the attack here tonight. Certainly proven that in these first three games at home, he's a crowd favorite. So far, it seems as though they're not thinking too much about Rick Barry right now, in this particular game, anyhow.
I would say not. You know, you mentioned Lucas. He scored 18 points in the first half and didn't get up on the board in the second half. Phil Smith leads the Warriors with 25 points. And so the young Golden State Warriors have blown away the world champions. As we remind you tomorrow, don't miss the CBS Sports Spectacular. And on Sunday, the NFL Today, 1/2 hour before our regionalized coverage. For John Havlicek, I'm Brent Musburger. Good night.
Oh, wait. Okay. We didn't.